Hello everyone, welcome you all on this online study platform. Myself Kainat Banu. So without wasting any time, let's start. Lesson 4, that is roots and flowers. Here in this lesson we have to discuss about plants, parts of a plant, types of roots, flowers, types of flower, parts of a flower, uses of flowers, and assignment. So let's start. Plant. Plants are one of the largest group of living things. The body of a plant is made up of different parts that perform different functions. They help plants to grow, obtain food, and stand upright. Children's As we know that, like animals, plants also have different parts performing different functions. It means plants are one of the most important things on the earth. Without plants, there would be no food to eat and no oxygen to breathe. Here are the picture of plant. It consists of leaf, fruit, flower, stem, and root. Now, parts of a plant. The body of plant is divided in two parts, shoot system and root system. Shoot system. The part of the plant that grows above the ground is called the shoot. It grows upwards. It consists of stems, branches, leaves, flowers, and fruits. Together, they make up the shoot system. Now, root system. The part of the plant that grow below the ground is called the root. It grows deep down inside the soil. Children, look at this picture of a full plant. You will observe two main parts in the plant, shoot system and root system. The part which remain under the ground is called the root system, and the part that grows above the ground is called the shoot system. Below the soil we have the root, and above the soil we have main stem, branch, leaf, flower, and fruits. Plants have different parts, and each part has different role to play. Like flowers help in reproduction, leaves perform photosynthesis. Children, do you know what is photosynthesis? The process of making food of plant with the help of water and sunlight and carbon dioxide is known as photosynthesis. Fruit protects the seed. Stem, it supports the plant. Root, it absorbs water and minerals. So that's all about parts of a plant. Now, types of root. The roots always grow down into the soil to form the base of a plant. From the main root, a number of roots arise. The roots are differentiated into two kinds, the tap roots and the fibrous root. So here in tap roots, the main root grows vertically downwards into the soil. It has many smaller and thinner roots called root hair along the sides, example carrot, radish, etc. Fibrous roots. These are a cluster of roots coming out of the stem. The roots are not branched but are made up of thin thread like roots of equal length coming out of the stem. Fibrous roots do not go deep into the soil, example wheat and grass. Look at the example of taproot and fibrous root. In the taproot system, there is a single main root from which the secondary and the tertiary root arise. And in the fibrous root system, a bunch of roots grow from the base of the stem. That's all about taproot and fibrous root. Now, function of roots. Roots hold the plant firmly to the ground. They prevent the plant from getting uprooted by strong winds or storms. Roots bind the soil and prevent the soil from being blown away by wind or washed away by water. Roots help a plant to absorb water and minerals from the soil. The roots of some plants, such as carrot and ginger, store nutrients and food in them. It means that the main function of roots are fixation, absorption, and storage. In a plant, you can find the root fixes the plant into the soil. It helps in absorption of dissolved mineral salts from the soil and supply them to the stem. Now, modified roots. The root of some plants go through changes in structure to perform more function. Both tap roots and fibrous root undergo change called modification. These roots are called modified roots. Some of them are storage roots. Some roots are modified to provide additional support to the tree or plant and to help it to stand upright. There are four types of support roots: prop roots, stilt roots, buttress roots, and climbing roots. Storage roots. Roots that store extra food are called storage roots. Example: carrot, radish, beetroot. Children, in some plant like carrot and beetroot, the root store excess food prepared by the plant, which swell up and become edible. The stored food is used by the plant later. Now, prop roots. Prop roots are aerial roots of trees. They hang from the heavy branches and grow vertically downwards and penetrate the soil. They become thick and look like pillars. They provide support to the spreading branches that fan out from the trunk of the tree. Sometimes they even replace the trunk or main stem. Here is an example of prop root of banyan tree. Stilt roots. Stilt roots are aerial roots that grow from the lower part of the stem and give an additional support to a plant. They are short and provide support to a plant like the ropes of a tent. Example, stilt root of a palm tree. Buttress roots. Buttress are found in trees that grow in areas where the soil is not very rich in water and minerals and do not grow deep into the soil. As the tree grows bigger and taller, their roots cannot provide enough support to the tree to stand straight. Therefore, buttress roots grow from the trunk of the tree, sticking out at the base on the top of the ground to provide additional support. Example, buttress of a fig tree. Now, climbing tree. Climbing roots are aerial roots that arise from weak stemmed plants to help them climb up a support. They climb on an external support structure to expose their leaves to sunlight. Example, climbing roots of betel. Breathing roots. Breathing roots are found in plants that grow in salty water and marshy regions. The soil in these regions has little air, therefore, the roots of these plants grow vertically above the water to absorb air. Example, breathing root of mangroves. Children, as we know that flowers are the most beautiful parts of the plant. Flowers differ in size, in color, shape, and size. Flowers grow in single or in bunches. So देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ फ्लावर, फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स एंड नॉन फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स. मोस्ट प्लांट्स बेयर फ्लावर, दे आर कॉल्ड फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स. प्लांट्स दैट डू नॉट प्रोड्यूस फ्लावर्स आर कॉल्ड नॉन फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स. हियर इज एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स एंड नॉन फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स. नाउ टाइप्स ऑफ फ्लावर्स. Flowering plants that complete their life cycle in 1 year are called annuals. Example, petunia. Flowering plants that complete their life cycles in 2 years are called biennials. Example, primrose. Perennials. Plants live for 3 year or more than 3 year is called perennials. Example, lavender. Some flowers are seasonal. Tulips, daffodils, and carnation bloom in spring. Dahlia, petunia, and pansy are winter flowers. Marigold, sunflower, and salvia flower during summer. Example, dahlia. Now, parts of a flower. Here we can see the parts of a flower are petal, stamen, which consist of anther, filament, sepal, stigma, style, pollen tube, ovary and ovule, it all about in carpel, receptacle and stem. So children, as we know that all flower grows from buds. These are stems, primary growing point, bud open to bloom into a flower. A flower has four main parts: sepals, petals, stamen and pistil. Sepals are the leaves that cover a bud to protect it before it becomes a flower. They support the petals of a flower. The petal is the color part of a flower. It is often bright color and scented. The stamen is the male part of a flower. It contains filaments and anthers. Anther contains pollen grains which look like yellow powder dust. Filaments are stalks that support the anthers. The pistil is the female part of the flower. It has three parts: stigma, style, and ovary. The stigma is the sticky tip of pistil. The long neck of the pistil is called the style. The broad base of pistil is called the ovary. And it contains one or more many eggs called ovules. So that's all about the parts of a flower. As we know that the stamen is the male part of a flower. It contains filament and anthers. The pistil is the female part of a flower. It has three parts: stigma, style, and ovary. Pollination. Children, the transfer of pollen grains from the male part, that is stamen, to the female part, that is pistil, is called pollination. It means pollination occur when pollen grains from the male part of one flower are transferred to the female part of another flower. These are called pollination. There are two types of pollination: self-pollination and cross-pollination. Now, uses of flowers. Some flowers such as broccoli, cauliflower and moringa flowers are eaten as vegetables. Hibiscus, chrysanthemum, rose, chamomile and basil flower are used as tea. Some flowers such as cloves, saffron and capers are used as spices. Holy basil, passion flower and calendula flower are used as medicines. Some more uses of flowers are: flowers are used for making clothes, dyes and organic colors. Flowers are used to decorate homes by making rangolis during festival or functions. Bouquets of flowers are used to greet or welcome people. Flowers are also used as motifs. Now, flowers from the market. Florists are people who sell flowers in the market. They buy flowers from a wholesale market or mandi. Sometimes flowers are brought from other countries too. Some florists make beautiful garlands and sell them. The price of the flowers depend on the season it is available in. Flowers are one of the most beautiful creation of nature. That's all about this lesson. I hope you all have understood. Now, assignment. Find out the answer of these questions and learn it. What are the parts of a plant? How many types of roots? What are the parts of a flower? What are the uses of flowers? And learn two examples of perennial flowers. Thank you and have a nice day.